Well, hi, everyone.
Hi, Todd. Thank you for doing this at the last minute. Tara is sick tonight with either a spider bite or MRSA. The doctors don't know which.
Yeah, when it comes to MRSA, there's nothing worse. So I really sympathize with her. I've had it many times now. I just have MRSA living in me. It is awful. And the second she described her symptoms, I was like, that's MRSA. That's
fucking MRSA. Yeah, it's a antibiotic-resistant version of the staph bacteria.
Well, they have found antibiotics that do work on it, and that should help for a while. But if she's got the IV, and she was describing it online, it sounded real bad. It sounded real bad.
Yeah, the word lancing was involved.
Yeah, I've done that. It's real bad. It's not good.
But Todd, you graciously volunteered at the very last minute to step in. Well, I asked you, and you said yes. That's not exactly volunteering, but yeah, you stepped in at the last second. Thank you very much.
I
appreciate it.
I could be playing video games right now.
you plan on getting Shadow of Mordor?
What's that? Is that a game?
Yes.
Yeah, I know you were talking about it earlier. I only play things that are like 7 years old because that's what works on my computer. I'm playing Psychonauts right now. I literally am playing Psychonauts right now. So.
I know you guys got a PlayStation.
Yeah, we got a PlayStation, but I don't know. I feel like I got a lot to catch up on, you know?
You got a backlog you have to work through.
Yeah, I've heard good things about this series called Call of Duty, and I've been meaning to play these Final Fantasy games I heard about. Oh, yeah. and something called Chrono Trigger.
you're just begging them to freak the hell out, aren't you?
Well, what am I doing here? I really can't see through this thing. I can't find my good mask. This is actually a sack for like a bag of Scrabble tiles.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting because I'm going to have to read you the stories as opposed to, well, I've been sending you the links, but I don't know how much you're going to be able to do with them, but that's okay.
Well, yeah, send me the links anyway.
Yeah, you're just kind of like, you need like the voice reader to read you shit for you. Anyway, there we go. Each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible things, bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck is Wrong with You? And we've got a cavalcade of assholes to start off this week.
No!
Yeah, there's crazy and there's dumb, but then there's the kind of malignant assholery that we have to deal with. And this first one...
Oh, not the fun kind.
Well, I guess in a way, this is the fun kind. This is the point and laugh and, yeah. This is the back to your mother's basements sort of thing on the first one. Have you seen the Cub Scouts? Have you been out lately at the stores? The Cub Scouts are selling popcorn. Have you seen them?
No, I don't leave this room.
Oh, okay. Because Callie is too small.
Oh, she needs to be tended because she's too small.
She's too small. We were just at, this last week, my girlfriend and I, we were just at Walmart, and of course, Cub Scouts were out front. They're like, would you like some popcorn? You know what my response was?
What?
No, thank you. Have a nice day.
Oh.
Simple, easy, not an asshole, right?
Right.
This man had a different, took a different path with this, with this. Wisconsin man wielding sword menaces Cub Scouts selling popcorn door to door. A man wielding
Wisconsin Knights have swords?
Apparently they do.
Yep, that's a guy who has a sword, all right. Look at him.
A man wielding a large sword menaced a group of Cub Scouts who knocked on his door as they sought to sell popcorn to fundraising drive, Wisconsin police report. After the children knocked on the door of his Sparta residence, Owen Reese, 22, oh my God, he lives in Sparta, Wisconsin. That makes it worse. Owen Reese, 22.
Good thing they didn't ask for, like, you know, earth and water.
Yeah. He opened the door, holding a sword above his hand, and immediately began yelling at them, according to the cops. While holding the sword over his head, he, and, quote, motioning like he was going to swing at them, Reese got within 5 feet of the Cub Scouts before they, quote, escaped unharmed. Now, here's the best part of the story. When cops arrived at Reese's residence, he again answered the door holding the sword at both hands at shoulder height. He dropped the weapon when officers leveled their guns at him.
So I have to assume this wasn't about the Cub Scouts. It's just something he does.
Well, apparently, Reese told officers he always answers the door with a sword to protect himself against religious people.
We all make fun of Jehovah's Witnesses, God. They're annoying. Like, wasting your time leaving that Watchtower crap on there. But I've found that defending myself from them is not hard.
No. Please, they're very polite, too. If you say, please go away, they will.
But I guess this is like a more active deterrent. Like, if you're not harsh about it, they'll just keep coming back, you know?
Well, what? You don't think the trench coat with the Batman button on the shoulder there was a deterrent? Oh, my God. That is sad. Oh, and of course, subsequent search of Reese's home turned up, quote, a large number of knives and swords, as well as marijuana and several smoking devices.
I could have told you. I can see the guy's picture. I could have told you that.
If you have this stuff on your premises, what you want to do is not call attention to yourself.
I think he may have been on something a little harder than pot. But
I just, the fact that they, if you always answer the door with your sword raised, eventually this is not going to work out well for you.
Well, you got to defend yourself from those religious people. Like, you know, they come at you with a pamphlet, you come at them with a sword. There you go.
I thought the pen was mightier than the sword.
Nope.
No.
The sword is mightier.
Sword is mightier.
Yes.
I'll take the penis mightier for 100, Alex.
That's the Sparta way.
So that's our Sparta, of all the places, Sparta, Wisconsin. Oh, well, we have another asshole this week. I used to work What? What's wrong?
Another asshole?
Yes.
No way.
Another asshole. Okay. I used to work retail. I don't know if you've ever worked retail, but one of the most horrible things you have to deal with working retail is the bathrooms. Because customers will do... Yeah, you're saying right there. Customers will do the most horrific things in a public bathroom. Shit they would never think to do in their own home. They just become animals in public. Well, this guy took that to a new low. You've read it. St. Paul man charged with dumping nails down toilets.
Oh, no. That's how you get mutant albino nails in the sewers.
That's a movie right now. Someone's writing that. Nails. That's a
nail-a-gator.
Pam Nelson considered Nicholas Muhlenmaster a good customer and a nice guy. Still, the Starbucks supervisor said she wasn't entirely surprised to find that the St. Paul man was the one who flushed pounds of hardware nails down the toilet, causing a flood that required the store to close for hours. For one thing, authorities say employees noticed he spent more time in a bathroom than your average customer, which says a lot considering it's Starbucks. Which, if you're in New York, Starbucks has begun to actively post signs says this is not a public restroom.
Oh, there are no public restrooms. I see people pee on the sidewalk all the time.
Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun.
According to a criminal complaint filed last week, Muhlenmaster, 38, flushed pounds of nails down the toilet at several locations in Eagan, including Subway, Lian Chin, and a city transit station. Muhlenmaster's car was charged with first-degree criminal damage to property for orchestrating the dumps, which caused thousands of dollars to damage to sewer lines. Complaint says that in early to mid-August, Nails were found in the sewer line in the bathroom of an Egan subway on three occasions, and repairs were required. Just before the third plumbing problem was discovered, a white male in his 30s is spotted on a surveillance camera coming out of the restroom.
This is not answering my questions.
Why? Yeah. There's no... I've got to find... Is there a motive here?
Okay, is he trying to actively damage the sewer lines, or is he just trying to dispose of the nails? Like, is it like something he doesn't want traced back to him, like something he doesn't want to find in his garbage? Like, where did he get them? What is he using them for? Did he buy nails specifically to flush them?
Oh my god. He hit the nail on the head there. No, he hit the head with the nails. That's a Navy joke. You'll have to think about it for a second. There you go. No, apparently he what I'm gathering from this article is he specifically went out. We got one bag held a large number of silver 3-inch nails and a recent receipt from Home Depot for a pound of nails. So apparently he literally planned. He went to Home Depot, he bought the nails, and then he went around flushing them with local toilets.
Was he trying to damage anything, or is that just a fetish of him? Like, I'm in the public bathroom flushing nails.
This was a really weird fetish, if that's so.
Because what's it? Why is he doing this?
I don't know. If that's what it takes for you to get up, Viagra, man, it's time to invest in Viagra. Because if you find yourself going, man, I cannot get a stiffy for my life. Maybe if I flush some nails down the Starbucks toilet.
This is, I've watched a bunch of these. This is one of the weirdest. I don't get it. I don't get it.
I bet you if we Google search this, we'd find a porn site dedicated to dumping nails down the toilet. Just probably videotaping dumping nails down the toilet.
Like, is he trying to kill, like, the ghoulies or the critters or whichever ones come out of the toilet?
Wait a minute. Yeah, maybe he's scared because I've heard stories. I even heard a story on This American Life. A rat crawled up the toilet. It happens. Maybe he was just really scared. He's like, okay, I'm going to take a dump, but nothing going to bite my butt.
Well, you'd have to dump the nails first. And that, you got a toilet full of nails. So I'm not sure how that's better.
My plan seems to have backfired.
I mean, seriously, what happens if you're dropping a deuce and then it suddenly the toilet explodes? You've turned it into a nail bomb now. It's even...
I'm 12 because just the image of an exploding toilet in my head delights me on a juvenile level. And you too. I can see you're sitting there thinking of a toilet exploding. Now set it to
With nails. Exploding with nails.
And now set it to the 1812 Overture, and it gets better. Oh my god!
Oh my god.
Well, and just to our trio of assholes, I guess the first three stories are all assholes. All right. People in car chases obviously do not want to be caught with the evidence. That's why you get the stories of them throwing shit out the window, you know, throwing the bags out the window. They don't want to be caught with the drugs.
Yeah.
And that makes sense. Unless what you, the contraband you are carrying is stolen chainsaws. Duluth, Georgia, a high-speed police chase between two thieves and a Duluth officer had the sergeant dodging chainsaws in the middle of the road. And the picture's not great, but there is actually a dashboard cam picture there. It's kind of low res, but you could see chainsaws in the road. Duluth PD.
Man, these twisted metal games just get weirder and weirder.
Duluth police are working to enhance the video and get a better look at the faces of the two men caught on camera throwing stolen chainsaws at a police car. They were seen leaving Howard Brothers Hardware at around 1:30 a.m. Monday. The officer chased the minivan. He saw they drove the side of the road and tossed three chainsaws and a weed eater. Chase ended after about 3 minutes. Two men stopped the edge of Seagull Drive and abandoned the vehicle. They ran off into the woods. Police found 9 weed eaters and 2 more chainsaws in the back of the van.
They should have kept throwing them. One of them had to hit eventually. Were they running? Did they start the chainsaws?
That would be awesome.
This doesn't sound real. This sounds
sounds
made up.
The total cost of merchandise was almost $19,000. One of those chainsaws whacked the patrol car, causing about $3,000 in damage.
It's like the red shell from Mario Kart.
Mario Kart, man, you know Luigi, that look. He wishes he had a chainsaw. That's what's going on there. He wishes. He longs to be, because if he could, he'd be throwing fucking chainsaws at. $19,000. All right. Was this really worth it? Seriously.
How did they sneak five chainsaws under their jackets? Like,
well, apparently it's 1:30 a.m. They broke in. There was a store alarm went off. So they broke into a hardware store and made off with chainsaws and weed whackers.
What? To sell on the black market? What?
People are saying, VG Paul, chainsaw juggling, you're doing it wrong.
Well, you know, the only way this story could be better if they, like, set them on fire and then threw them on...
Also play a... That would have made it perfect.
I just imagine being the cop in that situation. It's like, we got perps, we're chasing them down, and then they start throwing chainsaws at you. You would think you were dreaming.
Central suspect just threw a chainsaw. He just threw another chainsaw.
Yeah, like, chainsaw-related crimes are actually kind of rare. Even Texas chainsaw car chase.
We have our title. We have our title. Oh my god, what? Of all the things to just... That is desperation at that point.
Chainsaws. Like, what? Are they... Is there a black market for, like, unlicensed chainsaws that you... They sell with guns and stuff, like...
I hope not. Like,
does the ATF have to get involved?
I don't know. But speaking of law enforcement, okay, I'm going to ask you this as someone who's been to the American South. You know what okra is, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you understand, you comprehend what okra is. You may have even seen an okra plant at some point in your life.
Yeah, it's asparagus-y.
Okay. Could you really mistake okra for anything else?
Not really, I guess.
Maybe green bananas if you didn't have glasses on.
Maybe, like I said, like really thick asparagus, maybe, or I don't know.
Yeah. Well, the police in Georgia might need some LASIK surgery because okra mistaken for pot in man's garden.
Did you say pot?
I did indeed say pot.
Okay, I keep hearing pot. Sorry, there was an ad playing. Did you say pot?
I said pot.
Okay, I have never smoked pot in my life. It's not my thing. Don't like the idea of smoking, period.
But you've seen a pot leaf, right?
Yeah.
You've seen the pictures of them. I've seen them.
They're not even the same shade of green.
No. Cartersville man is upset after he said investigators mistook a garden full of okra for marijuana plants. Man growing the popular southern food said a helicopter woke him up Wednesday and then he had deputies show up at his door. I was actually scared at first. I didn't know what was going on. There was a chopper sitting unusually low over his house. Then Bartow County deputies and a canine unit appeared at the door. Turned out the helicopter was from the governor's task force for drug suppression and they were out looking for domestic cannabis plants and spotted the okra. Now listen to this. This is an official statement from law enforcement. They have the plants in their hands. They have pictures of them. They know. We have not been able to identify it as of yet, but it did have a number of characteristics that were similar to a cannabis plant.
Yeah, it's a plant.
That's about as far as it goes.
Yeah, like in the sense it has leaves, it grows out of the ground. You could have said the same thing of a potato plant.
These are the people who are supposed to be looking for drugs, and they don't even know what the fuck the drugs look like.
Did I think the canine unit was just hungry for gumbo, maybe. I don't.
And I love how, man, the fucking overreaction. I love how they come out to this poor bastard's house in force. And I don't, you know what I don't see in any of this? You know, I don't see a single thing in the story. An apology. their reasoning is, it looked like marijuana. It's not our fault.
This sounds like a prank gone wrong. like they were going to use the okra to be like, hey, it's marijuana. Smoke this, guys. And then somehow the cops got involved.
Oh, my God. How much of our money has gone to the war on drugs? And we have cops who don't even know what the fuck the drugs look like.
If they're going to confiscate anything, confiscate lima beans, man. Those are gross. I'll blow those. One grows those. But okra's fine.
What is this? Is this drugs? No, that's a bottle. Is this drugs? Is this drugs? That's a frog.
Mr. Magoo, the cop.
Seriously. I mean, they're supposedly trained to do. This is the governor's task force. This is what they are supposed to do for a living.
Guys, I have to say, I really don't support the war on okra. I think it's a waste of time. It's just putting people, you know, people who have a real problem with okra, throwing them in jail. It's not solving the problem, guys.
Although I will say okra is kind of nasty, depending on how you get it, because
I like it fried.
Yeah, because if it's just boiled, it's got like this slimy interior with like these little white seeds that look kind of like frog's eggs, and it's kind of gross. How my mom used to make it, and I was like, I don't like this. It's like mucus and shit on the inside. It's nasty. That's no reason to send in a fucking helicopter, though.
Yeah, nothing but seeds and stems, man. No one likes that stuff.
Well, god damn it. All right. We have more complete idiocy in terms of criminals. Okay. I tend to understand if you steal something, it's best not to advertise that you have stolen said object. Mm-hmm. You know, if you steal a car, you normally get rid of that shit. Or if, you know, you steal electronics, at the most, you keep them inside your house where no one can see you have them. But this guy, I guess he thought his haul was a little too good not to share. Man caught with stolen bouncy castle after he inflated it outside home. Thirty-nine-year-old dairyman who bought a large stolen bouncy castle worth £5,000 was caught by police after he inflated it outside his own home. Patrick,
well, where's he supposed to inflate it?
There's
not a good place to inflate it. I mean, you've already gone to the trouble of stealing it. You got to put it somewhere. You're going to either just sit around, not inflate it.
Police heard reports of a stolen bouncy castle worth £5,000 in that's British money that had been stolen in Codonegal. This was in, I believe, this Derry. I'm not entirely sure where this is. It's in the UK, at least. Police then found the bouncy castle, quote, fully inflated outside Coyle's home with electric cables and a pump running from his house to power it. So he couldn't even go, that's not mine, because the line's running right up to his door. He was also.
I just admire him. I don't see this as stupid. He's living the dream.
He was also now. This is a non sequitur. He was also convicted of handling stolen goods on May 9th, namely a stove. Who steals a stove?
This is, you know, you see people like steal like priceless works of art. And, you know, that's like, it's always clever. You have to dance through the lasers. But, like, this is the real challenging stuff. A stove. A bouncy castle. Next, I think he's just going to steal, like, a house.
Just put it on the back of a truck, take it home. What?
Yeah.
What? I didn't do nothing. Of all the... Do you not just think that maybe, possibly having it right in front of your fucking house might be a wee bit conspicuous.
I think this guy wanted people to know. He did want people to know. He didn't care if he got caught. He wanted people to know, and I would too. If I stole a bouncy castle, you would know. Oh. Matter of fact, nothing.
Is there something you're going to have to tell us later? Are you going to be on my show next week?
Oh, not next week. These things take time. But
New York internet personality steals bouncy castle. You know, at least DashCon paid for theirs.
I'm not sure they did, actually.
That's true. Well, they kind of embezzled. Let's say they embezzled theirs, more or less. But
yeah, pretty much.
That is just motherfucker. I have no respect for this. I want my criminals to have at least a higher level of competency.
He was stealing joy and sharing it with the world. They were stockpiling their joy and happiness. He's like the Robin Hood of joy.
Now, the article doesn't make it clear, because if he had just said, like, tell all the neighborhood kids to come over and bounce on the fucking castle, I would have loved him. Be like, okay, sure. But, you know, you could have also been just, like, the one guy in the bouncy castle going to all the kids, ha! It's mine! Fuck you! My bouncy castle! You can't have it! In that case,
you know
he's
what?
A dick.
I admire both equally. That man's living the dream.
All right. We've got one more full story and then a little bit of an afterthought after this. But this last story, ladies, I'm sorry. I almost didn't want to use this story, but the very fact that I didn't want to use this story means I have to. If you are easily squicked, brace thyselves.
I'm not. I'm up for it.
Oh, God. This one comes from Colombia, not South Carolina, but this is Colombia, South America. Wow. You know what? I'm just going to let the headline speak for itself for a second and let the channel react as it's going to react. And there you go. Kids, off to the races. I'm just going to step back for a second. Todd is getting it now. Oh. Doctors remove potato from woman's vagina. Woman complaining of abdominal pain at a Colombian clinic was found to have inserted a potato into her vagina 2 weeks earlier to keep from getting pregnant. Honda, Colombia. Workers at the clinic said a woman inserted a potato into her vagina as a means of contraceptive, and get ready to really be squicked, and the spud grew roots inside of her. Holy shit. Hold on, damn, we broke Todd. Wow. I broke Todd.
So the potato got pregnant.
Yes, she was pregnant with a potato.
No. The potato got impregnated, and it's going to have a baby now.
So it would seem.
Actually, does this work?
I don't know.
Are potatoes effective contraception?
God, I hope not.
I mean, just out of curiosity.
Well, no, okay, here's the quote from the patient. My mom told me if I didn't want to get pregnant, I should put a potato up there, and I believed her. Your mom was fucking with you!
Does it work with, like, does it have to be a whole potato? If it's like mashed or french fries or something.
What about a turnip?
Don't salt the french fries before you stick them up there. But
yeah. Maybe a beet or a rutabaga, perhaps a sweet potato, yam. Is this all tubers that have this contraceptive property, or just the potato?
Wow, this is. I guess it needs butter.
Oh.
Well, you got to get it up there.
Yeah, they were able to remove the spud without any surgery and do not expect the woman to experience any long-term effects from the experience, except perhaps a newfound aversion to using potatoes as contraception. You know, I remember being a kid. I remember being young, and I remember having those times when I was desperate to fuck. But never in my life have I ever been so desperate to fuck that I wish to include a potato in the process. Ever.
So, theoretically, what would happen if it just kept growing? I just imagine her becoming one with the potato woman.
Oh my god.
It'd be like, you know, The Fly, except instead of Jeff Goldblum, it'd be a Colombian woman with a potato.
And that's where Mrs. Potato Woman comes from. Mrs. Potato Head, there you go. We've learned the origin of Mrs. Potato Head. No clue how Mr. Potato Head happened, but Mrs. Potato Head we have down pat. Jesus, your mom, fuck that woman's mom.
Did it say what they did with the potato?
No. No, they didn't say what they did with the potato.
Did they keep the potato?
I don't think they kept the potato. It's not like, congratulations, it's a potato. I don't think that, no. I don't think they found a good home for it.
I'm just saying, like, you know. Kind of want to go get some hash browns now.
Oh, God.
I haven't eaten today.
Well, finally this week, we have a quick one before we get to what we've learned. A little bit of good old-fashioned American patriotism. And for this one, we've got video, and I'll send you the headline. This is a news story that was reported. I'm not entirely sure of the veracity, but it seems fairly well legit, so I'm going to go with it. Oh, my God. Well, we have drones in Syria right now, obviously, because we've deployed the air, you know, stuff for the bombing of ISIS and whatnot. And apparently, while out doing reconnaissance, one of the drones found a very interesting thing, and the picture's a little grainy, but I'm going to let you guys see if you can figure out what's happening there. What's going on in this picture? Can you figure it out? Let you see if you guys can spot that. Coalition drone catches ISIS member in a compromising position with a donkey. Coalition drone, which is active in Syria, captured these images. Yes, this happened. This fucking happened. Let me get the screen back up so we have the story up there on the screen. Not the potato. Go away, potato. The coalition drone, which is active in Syria, captured these images of what is believed to be an ISIS militant taking some time off to have sex with a donkey.
He's got the right to get a little ass.
You're fired.
He put a potato in there first, right? You don't want to get the donkey pregnant.
Oh my god. You know, that's just one of those things that, yeah, everyone's going, suddenly this terrorist group seems a little less terrifying.
Yeah, I can see why you had concerns that this might not be legit, because it sounds too good to be true.
It does, really, doesn't it? It sounds like one of those, no, really? Really? Oh, shit.
Yeah, like, I can just imagine, like, some CIA propaganda guys, like, how do we make these people look really stupid? Why overthink it? Let's go with the obvious one.
Can you imagine if they're there, the guys on the other end watching the drone, and they're controlling, and they're like, sir? I don't know how to report this activity, sir.
Yeah, that's just too easy. That's just too easy. That's That's like a joke. That's another thing that sounds like a joke that came to life.
We're observing the enemy's extracurricular activities, sir. They're not what we expected. Someone in the chat. That lady is sketch. Damn it, Jerry, you're making us look bad. Because you know when this came out, everybody at the compound turned and looked at the one guy. Just that slow.
I know we're terrorists, but come on, Jerry. I just imagined that guy saying to the donkey, he's like, "Don't worry, it's only me. No one will ever know." Then over the
okay, so what we've learned this week is number one, answering the door in certain ways is not advisable. You can get rid of religious people without resorting to weaponry. Probably, you know, just... We've learned that fetishes come in all shapes and sizes, including nails and toilet-sized.
I am going to see if that is an actual fetish, by the way.
Right now, probably someone's furiously Googling that shit.
Yeah.
And I guarantee you, by the end of this week, if that site does not exist now, it will by then. We've learned that getting rid of the evidence is probably a wise idea, except when it involves lobbing chainsaws at a police car. There's no time that's a good plan.
But now you can say it happened, and that's the important thing.
We've learned that cops can't tell the difference between common vegetables and marijuana. So I wonder if this is going to lead to a circumstance that goes, "Hey, is that marijuana?" No.
Oh, okay.
Okay, go ahead. Oh, God, someone said next Mario Kart DLC, Ash Williams. We've learned that, well, if you steal a bouncy castle, what else are you going to do with it?
Was he supposed to inflate it inside the house? Actually,
Well, then you'd bounce right the fuck through the ceiling. If you got drywall ceilings, your downstairs neighbor would be going, "What the fuck are you doing?" "I don't know!" Just be like a head, right about head and neck sticking through there. And finally, we learned you are never so desperate to have sex that you must involve a potato.
Or a donkey.
Or a donkey. Or God damn. That's real. That is just that people. I could just imagine them just beating the shit out of that poor bastard. What the fuck were you doing?
Well, I was feeding the donkey the potato, and then I thought, hey,